We're here at DSEI 2017. I'm talking to Steve Nendick, Communications Director, Cummins Engines. Cummins are showing a range of products at the show, including a new variation of their ISL9 engine. Steve, could you tell us a little bit about that engine, why you're focusing on it here at the show, and some of the targets for it?
Sure, thank you very much. The ISL9 has been around a few years in the military industry and in other markets such as trucks, bus, coaches. We developed already a spec for 450 horsepower for armoured vehicles, and now we're pushing it up to 536. So really for armoured vehicles such as 6x6, 8x8s, we see the demand for increased weight and carrying more people, and this extra power without increasing the weight of the engine provides a really good solution for our customers.
And from the technical side of things, could you perhaps go through some of the technicalities of the engine and how you got it from the lower power rating to the higher power rating?
Of course. So it's an inline six engine. Maximum horsepower for non-military use is around 400 horsepower. We have our own turbo division in Cummins, so we've taken a turbocharger with more sort of punch, if you like, with higher technology, and we swapped that with the one on the engine. We're also playing about with the combustion process as well to match that all up and get the responsiveness and the power that this industry is looking for.
And with that engine, or with all engines currently, the military are coming under increasing pressure from environmentalists to run their vehicles at currently Euro 6. What ratings does this engine have, and do you have any thoughts on the practicalities of running a modern Euro compliant engine on jet fuels and low grade fuels that you very often find on deployed operations?
So Cummins can supply engines basically any emissions level from non-emissionized up to Euro 6. So we've got a global emissions capability, and whatever our customers need we can supply. The challenge with the military is the quality of the fuel and the high sulfur. It has an impact on the operation of the after-treatment systems you need from Euro 4 onwards. So we can supply those, but there is a challenge. If you get high sulfur fuel in an after-treatment system for any length of time, it basically damages it and it can reduce the power of the engine. And that's not what you want in a military operation. So we found the best compromise is Euro 3 with the cleanest emissions without having to have any after treatment system on it.
Many people will have heard of Cummins as an engine producer, but perhaps not all of them will be fully aware of the scope of the organisation. Could you perhaps put into context the size and reach of Cummins as an engine manufacturer?
Absolutely. Cummins is 55,000 employees around the world. Last year we built close to 1 million diesel engines from 2.8 litres up to 95 litres. We supply engines into many, many segments from truck, bus, construction, agriculture, mining to defence. Defence remains a really important sector for us, but we basically produce diesels for any type of power that's needed.